Hi, Andrew here for tabletblog.de. In front of me I've got the Huawei MediaPad. It's a new 7-inch tablet from Huawei. It's available in Germany right now for €399. And I think you can also get it in the US and the UK. And also in the US from T-Mobile. It's called the Springboard, I think, in the US from T-Mobile. Yeah, we want to unbox the Huawei MediaPad right now. Let's quickly do that. Here we have standard power plug. Actually, it's not that a standard power plug because most tablets, at least some, have a micro USB or mini USB plug here. Here we've got this special kind. Like on tablets like the Arcos tablets or so. So you can't charge your Huawei MediaPad with your standard smartphone PCU. Okay, what else? Here we've got just a manual. Everything on the side. And what's in here? That's just an USB 2.0 to 2 micro USB. Okay, that was in the box. Let's take a closer look at the Huawei MediaPad. It's a 7-inch tablet. Resolution is 1280 by 800. We've got the 1.2 megapixel camera on the front. Let's take a look at the sides here. We've got the power, HDMI out, micro HDMI out, micro USB port. That looks like a microphone here. Walker switch for the volume, power button, two speakers and audio out. And nothing here. On the back we've got a 5 megapixel camera, a nice aluminium, and under here it's a little bit hard to get off. That looks like you have to do it that way. Yep, it works. Here we've got a SIM card slot, so there's a 3G module inside and also a micro SD card slot. Okay, let's put this back on. There we go. And yeah, let's turn the Huawei MediaPad on. Here we've got the power button. Now it vibrates. I already set up the Wi-Fi and Gmail and so on because I unboxed it for the German video. Yeah, inside the Huawei MediaPad we have a 1.2 GHz dual core processor, 1 GB of memory, 8 GB storage. Again, new 3G module is inside, 1.2 megapixel camera on the front, 5 megapixel camera on the back, €399 in Germany, and yeah, 7-inch display resolution 1280 by 800. So it's the biggest resolution for a 7-inch tablet that we can get right now. The only other tablet, 7-inch tablet with this kind of a resolution is the Galaxy Tab 7.7 that was shown at IFA in Berlin, but it's not out yet and we don't know when, so this will be the biggest resolution for a 7-inch tablet for a while. On here we've got Android 3.2 Honeycomb and it's loaded right now. Wi-Fi is set up. So let's go quickly through the menus here. No lag from switching through the home screens. Looks good. Let's have a look at the apps here. We've got Alico Reader, Angry Birds, Asphalt 6, and Let's Golf 2 is pre-installed, which is nice. And yeah, the other apps are pretty standard: Gmail, Latitude, Maps, Facebook, Twitter. We've got the Yotsu Office, it's normal Office, which is pre-installed. Let's just start something. There's a keyboard. Okay, that works pretty good. And here we see it, it's a pretty high resolution. Even if we zoom out and you can't really, if you go close, then you can still can read the text without any pixels or so. Yeah, that's the Office app that was pre-installed. Let's take a quick look at the settings to see if it's really Android 3.2 Honeycomb. And indeed it is. So let's just start the browser. Type in maybe Engadget. Oh no, now we see the mobile version. So let's go to a German website where now that's just go to tabletblock.de. We don't have a mobile version here, so we can really test it. Okay, loads pretty fast. No problem scrolling. No lag here. It takes a. If you scroll really fast, you see this blue rendering stuff, but only if you really scroll really fast. So, no problem here. Multi-touch is okay. So, you can zoom in nicely and out again. If we zoom out, it has to render a little bit. But it's still pretty fast. Yeah, let's start S-File 6. Again, this was pre-installed, which is pretty nice, I think. Most tablets don't have such apps. And it's loading. There we go. By the way, it feels pretty nice in the hand. It's a little bit lighter than the HTC Flyer. Just a little bit. Just the normal ways. Start. There, it's loading. The aluminium feels really nice here. Let's have a look at the viewing angle. While we see this beautiful introduction. Viewing angles are pretty good here. As you can see, it's an IPS display. No problem viewing from angles like this. That's great. Okay, start, start. And I have to. Yep, works pretty good. No lag here in the video. And the graphics. So works fine. Yeah, that's the Huawei MediaPad. I think it's a pretty nice tablet. We haven't heard anything about Android Ice Cream Sandwich, so I don't know if there will be an update. I certainly hope so. In the coming days, I will test this tablet further because 7-inch tablets are my favorite tablets. I daily use the HTC Flyer. And let's see if the Huawei MediaPad is a little bit better, if I can use it really every day, if I want to use it every day. Yeah, you will hear about that in the review video that will be up in a couple of days on this YouTube channel and on Tablet Blog. Dot de. Das ist die Huawei MediaPad.